Mr. Wynans, thanks for joining us today to discuss Aegon's second quarter results. Give us a feel for how you feel the business performed, and especially in this period of continued turmoil.
Well, I'm very pleased to announce today that we have had a good performance on our businesses. If you measure that in terms of earnings or in terms of sales, despite this difficult environment, we've had good results. Our underlying earnings, they've increased as a result of growth of our business, the actions we're taking in order to reduce expenses, and obviously also foreign exchange has helped. If you look at sales, we see continued improvement in the trend, particularly in the deposit area, pension business in the US, asset management, and I'm pleased to see that this core part of our business is continuing to grow very well. Capital position remains strong. As you can see, the best way is the fact that we are announcing the payment of an interim dividend of 10 cents a share. And I'm very pleased to be able to make this announcement today.
Net income. Let's talk about net income for a moment. There was a one-time charge there that considerably impacted the results, but still beating analysts' expectations. Could you explain that?
The one-time impact you mentioned is what we announced on the 31st of May, that we are going to make further improvements in our products for our unit-linked policies here in the Netherlands. That's a charge we've taken, 265 million euros, and that now impacts our second quarter numbers. This charge is related to further improving the products. It's part of our commitment to ensuring that we are best of class in the Netherlands. It's also part of our commitment to contribute to further improve the level of trust in our industry and in Aegon in particular.
Let's spend a moment on the persistent low interest rate environment, not particularly good for your type of business. How is Aegon dealing with this reality?
Well, if you look at the low interest rate environment, then it is absolutely correct that it is not positive for the industry in general. I'd like to make the point here on Aegon is that effectively the low interest rate environment is not yet affecting our in-force business. And this is because we have matched our assets and liabilities at the same level. So where it has an impact is for new business, and it's clear that in this environment customers are hesitating to commit to life insurance contracts at this low level of interest rates. So that's why we are now focusing on redesigning our products. We are actually even shutting down certain lines of business, and that's what you see in terms of development and sales in health products in the US in particular. These products are much less sensitive to interest rates. So we're taking really clearly action to adjust ourselves into this environment of low interest rates.
A fair question on the excess capital, perhaps by your shareholders, is how will you use this level of excess capital?
Well, we've been consistent in saying that in this environment in particular, but also in general for Aegon, as a strategy going forward, we will be looking at always maintaining a very strong capital position, including a buffer. In particular, right now, having this buffer is not a luxury, and that means that we will keep and maintain this capital within Aegon. I am pleased, however, to say that we are going to pay a small part of it in the form of an interim dividend of 10 cents a share in August.
Having a strategy is one thing, executing it is quite another. So let's talk about how Aegon has executed strategy during the second quarter.
Well, I believe that the numbers which we're showing now for the second quarter clearly demonstrate that we're executing on our strategy. Let me share with you a few examples. First of all, what we see is that the work we're doing, big efforts we're putting in reducing our expenses is paying off. We see that very clearly in all our markets in the US, we see that in the Netherlands, in the UK. Our costs are 4% lower on an equal basis than what they were a year ago. That's a big achievement in this environment. Second thing we're seeing is also our aim to have a more balanced fee versus spread income generation is also working. Our pension business in the US is continuing to grow. Our variable annuities business in the US is also growing. And you see that our spread business is declining. So it's a very clear sign that we are executing on our strategy. At the same time, we also committed to invest for the future. And I'd just like to share with you a couple of examples. In the UK, with the new environment, the RDR environment, and the environment where it's not allowed to pay any more commissions for life and pension products, we are well positioned by investing into a platform proposition, both for the retail and the workplace or the employer's point of view. India is one other specific area I'd like to mention. We just recently launched, it was a very successful launch, a new direct product, and it's a health insurance product which is sold online with no intermediary. It's a fully automated system. And that is the kind of examples which I'd like to share with you, showing that we are not only dealing with being more efficient with our enforced business, but we continue to invest for the future, and as such we'll be well positioned to be able to see the significant opportunities we see ahead of us.
Spain is a country where you've been very active for quite a number of years, and you've identified that market as a key growth region for you, given your core business. How are you dealing with the rather severe turmoil underway in Spain?
It's absolutely clear that Spain is undergoing a very severe economic downturn. It's also clear that there's a lot of changes taking place in the landscape, the banking landscape in particular. Aegon has been there for many years, has developed very successfully a bank distribution model. There was a bank distribution model with quite a number of regional banks and regional savings institutions. What we're now seeing is a consolidation, and the result of that, Aegon will be exiting its joint venture with Banca Cívica, which has been taken over by CaixaBank. We have announced actually this morning that we have concluded a deal whereby we'll actually realize a profit, and at the same time we are continuing with our arbitration process with Caja Mediterráneo, which is another bank assurance distribution agreement we had in place. So by doing so we'll be exiting two of our four distribution agreements and reducing as such our exposure to Spain.
So in reducing your presence by half, what does it mean for your business going forward?
Well, we believe that on a long term, the Spanish life insurance market is an attractive market. The market is underinsured. People need to take care of their own responsibility. It fits very much within our purpose. Spain is a large country. Spain is undergoing clearly severe economic difficulties right now, but I'm also convinced that they will get out of it over a period of time. And as such, it remains an attractive long-term market.
So, Mr. Vynants, all in all, you feel pretty good about where Aegon stands today. Is that a fair assessment?
Well, I believe that in this difficult environment, we are taking the right actions. And we've seen the results in the numbers. We've seen the results in a strong capital position. I also believe that the fact that we announced the interim dividend is, again, a sign of confidence in the strength of our balance sheet, but also a sign of confidence in the future. We're taking measures to be well prepared for what we see a changing environment. I gave a couple of very clear examples for the UK, the Netherlands, but in all of our markets we are looking at realizing the full potential of what we have to offer to our customers. Our customers will continue to look more and more in this uncertain environment for security, income guarantees. This is at the core of our business. So I believe actually if you look at the general environment, we are not only well positioned in that environment, but the need and the demand for our products has never been as big. So I'm confident, yes.
Good. Well, thank you for your time.